the nice mountain, let's say, it will be my sixth trip, because already I have been five times on K2 from all over the side. I climb only one time, but it means that I spend there more than 1 year. So why not? We start with the Everest winter, so now we can finish with the K2. In winter, I don't know. I know, because I was twice on K2 in years 80s and 2002. Both sides are the same. Same winter, same strong winds, same storm. So we do not expect so nice weather. Yeah? We expect that it will be hard winter. But you know, we have to try, because if we not try, we not climb. And our friends from Europe, they don't want to go. Nobody wants to climb K2 in winter. So they say, no, this is the goal for Polish climbers. Okay, so if they say like this, finally, we're thinking since last year about, but we couldn't find the budget money for the expedition. We are lucky that this year we have the big help of the Ministry of Sport, and we are able to prepare expedition. So I think third attempt, I hope, will be successful. We have to believe. But even if we are not success, it is important that we try to do. We do the attempt, yeah? Because if you don't try, you don't climb. So we have to go. And all my friends, they are very concentrated and determined to go there. Oh, 87, it was, you know, first we took the good lesson, you know, because we didn't know nothing about the winter in Karakoram. We had the knowledge about the winter in Himalaya, in Nepal, but nobody knows what happened in Karakoram. And it was a big surprise, because we are thinking that if we climb Everest, Kanchenjunga, lots of other things, so when we come to Karakoram, it would be very easy. It was not true. So we reached only 7,200 meters. My longest expedition, three months in base camp, 85 days. It's so long time. And we did quite nothing. 7,200, you know, a shame for it. But I remember that we have around 65, 70 days, stormy days. And we discovered that the Karakoram is more north mountain. So there is a lot of North Siberian influence for the weather. And the another problem with jet stream, that the K2 is the first big mountain. So this jet stream is the very strong, because the first mountain which stopped the jet stream. Yeah? So even on Broad Peak is hidden, it was better weather. So what for Maciek Berbeka, that time climbed the Presummit on Broad Peak in March 88. So we were not able, but it was a good lesson for us. And then after we were thinking still, because nobody tried again. So it was 15 years later. Zawada was thinking to come back again to K2, but he died in 2000. So he was just before leaving for reconnaissance to K2. So when he died, we decided that we should follow the idea of Andrzej Zawada, and we left to K2 again. But because we had a lot of problem on the glacier with porters, with, you know, during the autumn 87, so I knew the north side, because I climbed in 1996 K2 from north side, and I was sure that we'll have no problem with the approach march. It was very important, yeah? So we decided to get a permit from Chinese mountaineering club. And in 2002, we left to north side to China, let's say to Xinjiang. Yeah? And our expedition joined some people from post-Russia, I mean Denis Rubko, Pivtsov, Tukvatulin, Tortladze, four persons we have. And finally, only Denis Rubko stayed with us. And this time we climbed a little bit more. I mean, we reached 7,650, a little bit more than 16 years ago, but still 1,000 meters to the summit. And the weather was exactly the same like 15 years before. So it means jet stream. And what happened in the end of expedition, because after the first attempt, we were thinking that we can do the second attempt. But it was my experience. I saw after, during the winter climbing, that in the end of season, this jet stream come down. Not only in the high altitude, 7,000, 5,000, 8,000, but this jet comes down and destroy all our base camp, you know. Every day, 1, 2, 3 tents was broken. Mess tent, every day we have to rebuild. Kitchen, every day we have to rebuild. So after 1 week of the fight with the jet stream, we decided to come down. Because the jet stream is the northwest wind, the direction. So the K2 is the first high mountain, you know, for this jet stream, so the strongest, let's say, yeah? So this is the problem. No, and I think, you know, it's more north, and you see, even during the summertime, K2 has this special climate, it's a little different climate, I think. So I think it's more, less windows, lot of wind, and stormy day, so it's very high. With north, you could try, but you know, with Chinese authorities, sometimes it's a problem. They can close border, they can refuse permit, they can do something. In Pakistan, for this problems, we have not this problem. Yeah? So we decided again to come to from the south, from the Pakistani side. Especially that we have good relation with some agent. They had good experience now with the winter expeditions. So we are not afraid about the organization, approach march, yeah, so yes, from south we start. Or we follow the our Basque's route, which Tomo Chesson first tried the variant, but finally the Basque people, they climbed to the summit. Or Abruzzi Ridge, I don't know now, it's difficult to say me here, because it depends on the condition, yeah, in the mountain. So if there will be so much ice, I am not sure that we can follow the Basque route, because there is a problem with the bivouac places, because it's quite quite steepy face, but it's good because you can climb quite directly from the base camp. Otherwise, if you want to climb the Abruzzi Ridge, you have to go more right to make an advance camp, and where from you can start to the mountain, yeah? So seems faster, the Basque road to the shoulder. From shoulder, of course, there is the same road, yeah? You have to follow the bottles and Serag. And for me, the top point is, you know, 7, 8 bivouac. The last bivouac will be the hardest problem, because we have to sleep, let's say. You have to spend the half night, yeah, before the going to the summit. And still you have 800 meters minimum to climb, and you have to come back in a short day. So I think the other problem will be that I cannot imagine that we will be able to put the rope over 7, 8. Impossible. So it means that can be the key how to come down, because there is some 2, 3 parts very steep. So in my opinion, the summit team should have with them small rope, you know, light rope, just for any case that they will have to belay in the way down, because it can be very, very dangerous, I think. I'm not afraid of the climbing, you know. If they will have the power, they will climb. But for the way down, can be a problem. I know, because I've been there one time, and without rope, you know, 800 meters, you are exhausted, it's problem. It is impossible to put the rope over 8,000 meters, yeah? Nobody will do it. But I think they have to carry with them rope for coming down, you know, to make a belay. Or we have to send the second team who will help them, you know. So I'm thinking that we have the first team who will climb the summit, the second team will take care of them, yeah? I think first we have to climb in winter. If we climb, then after, welcome other people, they improve style, they can do solo, in small team, alpine style. But first, I think any style is okay to climb first time. Then after, you can look to the style. Yeah, especially that, you know, we did the two attempts. This third attempt, we cannot risk, you know, just to go in two or three people. Because if you go in such style, you are sure that you have the 1% of chance to climb. So if we have such money we've got from the Ministry of Sport, we cannot risk like this, you know. So we decided to do the little bit bigger team, and for the second, to give a chance to everybody, is the first. And the second maybe is the good school for some people, they didn't climb in winter. Yeah? Half younger people, half more experienced people. But almost the half of team, they climb already K2. It was important for us that on the beginning we were thinking that everybody who wants to go to the K2 in winter should climb K2 before. But it was impossible to find such team. But half of team, yes, five people, they climb already the K2. One or two were very close to the summit. So let's say almost the people, they know this mountain. This is very important to know mountain, especially in the upper part, yes. So if they know what is before, what they can expect, you know, in the high mountain, close to the summit. So it was the reason that we build a team with the people they climb already.
Well,
K2.
Now it's more
difficult, you know. 30 years ago, you have the 40 people and you can choose the 10. Now, I don't see more people than we bring to the K2. So it means that less and less. I don't know how it's working in Europe, but in Poland it's a little bit difficult. The people, you know, they try to climb, not in style we climb, you know, 30 years ago. So it's difficult to build a big team, like 10 people, yeah? Now it's not efficient to make the national expedition. But because we got the money from the Ministry of Sport, we have to follow this idea, you know, that it is national expedition. If we have the private sponsoring, of course, we will not do national expedition. We do expedition, we could invite people from Spain, Italy, you know, Russia or somewhere. But in this case, we cannot do like this, you know. It's not a problem to climb without oxygen. I think the problem is the winter in the mountain, not you use oxygen or not use oxygen. Because for sport people, actually people, they don't use oxygen. Yeah? If you have good acclimatization, you don't need, you know, oxygen. What for?
No.
We have, of course, but only for medical purpose.
No, I
will climb, of course, I will climb. I want to climb, but I don't think to the summit. I think we have to live for the younger people. They have to do something. Yeah? We did a lot, so. For me, the most important is that the old people come back home, you know. Even we will not climb the summit, the most important for me, especially after my experience, bad experience with Broad Peak 2013, I'm thinking the most important is if all people, they lucky, come back home. There's quite a kind of fight inside me, you know, or to be a sportsman or to be a leader. So no, rather as a leader I will work. Himalaya is better than Karakoram if we compare. If you mean Himalaya, Nepal, Himalaya. Yeah, in Himalaya, Nepal is a little bit better weather during the winter time because it's more east and Karakoram is more west, so the first wind is coming. So, as you see, if you see the story, the first people they climbed in Himalaya all the peaks, then after they moved to Karakoram because they saw just in 1990 the first attempts on Nanga Parbat. They saw that in Karakoram, in this part, west part, is very hard wind. Winter. So, but we have to try. There's the last 8,000 meter left unclimbed in winter. So,
and police want to make it. No?
Yeah, they want to make it because, you know, it could be the nice when we, if we will be able, of course, to climb, oh, it will be nice story. We start with highest Everest and we could finish with the second K2. Yeah. Climbing is the passion, yeah? You can climb up to the dead. So, No, it is not the point that you have to stop, no. Because, you know, we climb every time. We we are involved with the exploration in North Hunza mountain, so there is a lot of things to do. Not only K2 is, you know, the one mountain only. So, no, this is the important point, but not the only, you know, we still will climb.